Hello friends, welcome you all. In this today's lecture, we will discuss on the groundnut pest management. Because the groundnut is most important oilseed crop, and this groundnut it is affected by the different major and minor pests which reduce the yield and cause a severe losses, and we can say that the reduce the yield of the farmer. These are the different major and minor pest of groundnut. In that, sucking pest, defoliators, subterranean pest, borers and non-insect pest. Here in case of groundnut, the sucking pest, defoliators and subterranean pest are the most and major important pest which reduce the yield in very much quantity. Let us start one by one. The first category of the major pest is that the sucking pest. In that groundnut, there are three major sucking pests which infest the groundnut area or groundnut crop area. In that, the first one is the thrips, then we can say that the aphids and the leaf hoppers. Okay. And then here, this is the first and major pest, that is the thrips. There are near about the three species of the thrips which infest the groundnut crop. Scrotothrips dorsalis, Caryothrips indicus and Franklinella species. Okay. It is the Thysanopteran insects and having a incomplete metamorphosis and the three life stages, egg, nymphs and adult. The damaging stages of this pest is both nymphs and adult. The important or economic importance of this pest is that in case of groundnut, it is responsible for transmitting the tomato spotted wilt virus, and that virus which cause a peanut bird necrosis disease in a groundnut. Then now, how the both nymphs and adult it is actually damaged the groundnut crop. It is a sucking pest, but there is one difference in between the other sucking pest and the thrips is that in a thrips there is a right mandible is absent. Hence, during cell self-sucking at an initial condition, both nymphs and adult scrap the epidermal layers of the leaves and sucking the oozing cell sap. This is the difference between the other sucking pest and the thrips. It is present on the lower surface of the leaves and start their feeding. As a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the infested leaves shows a silvery whitey patches or white patches or spots on the surface of the leaves, and followed by curling and drying of the leaves occurs, and it also act as a vector for peanut bird necrosis virus. Then now, how we can manage this pest in groundnut crop? This is a major sucking pest. For monitoring purpose or for to attract the adults, we can use a blue sticky trap. It is one of the most important trap. Toward that trap, the adult thrips is attracted. Then Lecanicillium lecani, it is one of the effective bioagents or effective entomopathogenic fungus. It is used against the thrips or near about all the sucking pests. Then 5% NSK and the azadirachtin are the two neem-based product or botanical insecticide. It is very much used against the sucking pest and the lepidopteran pest. These are the recommended insecticides against the thrips: imidacloprid and acetapremiprid. These are the systemic insecticides, and systemic insecticide it is only used against the all types of sucking pest. The next sucking pest, leaf hopper or Jessids, scientific name is Ampoyis cacceri. It is also the hemipteran pest, hence having a three life stages, egg, nymphs and adult, and the damaging stages are both nymphs and adult. The female leaf hopper lay their eggs under the surface of the leaves, and after the hatching from the eggs, the nymphs emerge out. Then during feeding, both nymphs and adult suck the cell sap from the lower surface of the leaves. As a result of feeding, the plant lose their turgidity or vitality. During feeding, the most important things is that the nymphs and adult introduce their toxic saliva into the host tissue, and which produce a one characteristic symptoms in the groundnut crop, that is the hopper burn symptoms. And as a in case of severe infestation, the leaves showing a chlorotic patches and especially at the tips of the leaflet. Then in this picture you can see here the chlorotic patches at the tip of the leaflet, which is like a V shape, and under infestation severe, the broader leaves turn to reddish and sometimes dry up. Then for the management practices, Lakenicillium lakeni, it is one of the entomopathogenic fungus. I have already told you, this is mostly used against all types of sucking pests. Then NSK and azadirachtin is also used, and imidacloprid and acetamiprid are the systemic insecticide you can also use against all types of sucking pest. The next sucking pest, groundnut aphids, that is the Aphis crachyvora. There is one important things about the aphids is that here the aphid, it is reproduced by means of viviparously and parthenogenetically. It means that instead of the egg laying, the female aphids, it directly gives birth to the young ones. Here in this picture you can see the aphids, it is congregated on the lower surface of the leaves or the tender shoots and start their feeding. The both nymphs and adult are the damaging stages, and they suck the cells up from the tender leaves, leaf buds, flowers, and as a result of feeding, the plant lose their turgidity and vitality, and it is adversely affect on the yield. Beside feeding, the aphids is excrete a honeydew like substance or sugary material that are responsible for the development of black sooty mold fungus on the plant parts. And the species of the black sooty mold fungus is Capnodium species, which is black in color. Hence the infested plant parts become blackish in appearance, and it directly affect on the photosynthetic rate, and the photosynthesis is directly reduced and yield is indirectly reduced. Besides feeding, this pest is also act as a vector for the peanut strip virus and also the groundnut rosette disease or groundnut rosette virus. Then for management practices, these are the some of the recommended insecticides against the aphids. Then beside this, we can also use the Lakenicillium lakeni, is the entomopathogenic fungus. Then 5% NSK. Then also we can also use neem oil or azadirachtin, and coccinellid beetle are the important predators against the aphids. And we can also use the Chrysoparla carnea greenless wing. The next category of the pest is defoliator. It means that these all defoliator pests which act or infest the only loose and completely defoliate the plant. The first is leaf miner, Aproierma modicella. It is the Lepidopteran pest. The egg laying of this pest, it is takes place on loose and tender shoots. Then the caterpillar is emerged out under caterpillar. It is mines on the surface of the loose, and also webbing of the loose occurs and feeding in the conceal condition. Then after the development of the larva goes into the pupation, and the pupation occurs in leaf fold or in the leaf mines. Here in this picture we can see here, as a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, at an initial condition, the neonate larva means early install larva, mines into the epidermis of the leaves and feed within, and the third instar comes out from the mines and web the 2 to 3 leaves together and feeds within. It means that the early instar larva feed in the leaf fold, and after the third instar larva, the webbing or emerge from the mines and webbing and feeding on the 2 to 3 leaves together. Okay. Then this is the severe infestation of leaf miner, and as a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the whole field look like a burned out appearance. It look like this. Then how we can manage leaf miner in groundnut? The early and synchronized sowing, then crop rotation with non-host crop or non-leguminous crop, then intercropping with pearl millet or cowpea, then avoid water stress in the irrigated crops, and we can also use or set up the light trap, one trap per acre for mass trapping of the adults. And the next most important preventive measure is that the bunch variety of the groundnut is more susceptible to the leaf miner. Hence we can avoid this variety and sowing with spreading varieties. Then intercropping, which is recommended in groundnut to minimize the infestation of the leaf miner, that is the intercropping with groundnut. Then These are the some of the botanical insecticide like neem seed kernel extract 5% and azadirachtin. Then these are the some of the recommended chemical insecticides, spinosad, flubendavide and lambda-cyhalothrin against the leaf miner. Then next one is tobacco leaf eating caterpillar. It is one of the oleophagus pest. Female moth lay their eggs on the surface of the leaves in a bunch or in a cluster or in egg masses. Then after hatching from the eggs, the early instar or the nunat larva is emerge out, and the early instar larva feed gregariously on the upper surface of the leaves and scraping the green tissue or scraping the epidermal leaves from the lower surface of the leaves. As the larvae grow, they spread into the entire field and feed voraciously on the surface of the leaves. The late instar larva make a symmetrical holes on the surface of the leaves, and in case of severe infestation, the plant is completely defoliated. These are the some of the recommended practices or management practices against the tobacco leaf eating caterpillar. For monitoring purpose, you can use a sex pheromone trap with a spodolure at the rate of 2 to 3 trap per acre for to trap the male moth of the Spodoptera litura. Then preventive measures in deep summer plowing we can follow. Then growing a castor or sunflower as a trap crop against the tobacco leaf eating caterpillar in groundnut. Then in curative control, at an initial condition, we can collect and destroy the egg masses. Then also we can collect and destroy the late instar or early instar larva of the Spodoptera litura. Then SLNPV, numerarily and Bacillus thuringiensis are the different recommended biopesticides against the tobacco leaf eating caterpillar. SLNPV, it means that Spodoptera litura nuclear polyhydrosis virus, that is the entomopathogenic virus. The numerarily is the entomopathogenic fungus, and Bacillus thuringiensis is the effective entomopathogenic bacteria against the tobacco leaf eating caterpillar. Then emamectin benzoate, novaluron and lambda cyhalothrin are the recommended insecticides against the Spodoptera litura. Then next pest and next defoliator is the red headed hairy caterpillar. Amsectum uri or Aloe albustriga are the two species which infest the groundnut crop. After the male female mating, the female hairy caterpillar moth, it lay their eggs on the surface of the leaves in a cluster or in a masses. Then after hatching from the eggs, the caterpillar is emerge out, and the caterpillar is called as the hairy caterpillar because on the or all over the body of the caterpillar, it is a form a number of hairs, or it is covered with a number of hairs. The larva goes into the pupation, and the pupation occurs in soil. The diapaus stage of this red hairy caterpillar is the pupa stage, and which is occurs in the soil or present in the soil. These are the different larval instar of the hairy caterpillar which attack on the groundnut crop. The female moth lay their eggs on the surface of the leaves. Then after that, caterpillars emerge out, and the nunat larva at an initial condition feed by scraping the green tissue on under surface of the leaves, leaving upper epidermal layer intact. As they grow, the late instar larva feed voraciously on the surface of the leaves, and the plant look like this. The completely defoliation is occurred due to the feeding of the late instar larva, and in case of severe infestation, the infested field look like a graze by the cattle. Then these are the some of the recommended management practices against the red-headed caterpillar. We can use a bonfire or light trap. Then a deep summer plowing for preventive measures. Then we can grow the cowpea or sesamum or red gram as a trap crop. Then intercropping, which is recommended in groundnut to minimize the infestation of the red hairy caterpillar and the leaf miner. Then here, the curative measures, collect the egg masses as well as the young larvae and destroy them. Then collect the grown-up larva or late instar larva. Then after that, we can dig out the trenches around the crop field. We reduce the migration or prevent the migration of the red hairy caterpillar from one field to the another field, so we can dig out the trenches. Then dusting with malathion dust and fenolate dust, and also we can use a poison bait technique. Then next one is the Bihar hairy caterpillar, Spilozoma oblica. It is also one of the lepidopteran pests, and it is also acted the defoliators. The egg laying takes place on the surface of the leaves, and the larva, it is voraciously feeder on the leaves. The early instar larva scraping the epidermis of the leaves, and late instar larva, it is scattered all over the fields and feeding on the surface of the leaves, and completely defoliation occurs in case of severe infestation. Here, some of the management practices for the Bihar-Eri caterpillar deploying is, we can follow, then destruction of alternate wild host and weeds which is present around the fields, the destruction of egg masses, then place the twigs and leaves of Calotropis, Jatropha and Papaya around the field to trap grown of the larva, because the hairy caterpillar larva, it is attracted toward the leaves of the Calotropis, Jatropha and Papaya leaves. Then we can grow up the trap crop like a cowpea, castor and Jatropha on field burns to attract the caterpillars. Then we can also conserve the biocontrol agents. These are the different biocontrol agents we can conserve, and it will be helps to control the BR hairy caterpillar. Then we can spray the crop with NPV virus, that is a nuclear polyhydrosis virus, against this pest. Then Cunalphos, Chlorpyrifos and Dichlorphos are the recommended insecticides against the BR hairy caterpillar. Then next one is a root and pod feeders. It means that it is a subterranean pest, or it is attacked from the soils on the roots and the pods. This is the first and major pest of the root feeders, that is the root grub, also called as white grub. There are the two species, Holotrichia serrata and Holotrichia consanguinea, which attack on the groundnut crop. After the first monsoon of the first shower of the monsoons, the female beetles of the white grub, it is emerge out from the soil, which is hibernating in the soil, which is emerge out after the first shower of the monsoon. Then it is attracted towards the adult host. The adult host of this pest is that neem, bear, bel, babul, shevga. These are the different recommended adult hosts which is present on our field burns, and the adult beetle which is feeding on the leaves of these adult hosts. Then at evening condition, the male female mating is takes place, and the female beetle it is settled down into the soil and lay their eggs inside the soil in earthen cocoons. Then after the hatching from the eggs, the milky white color larva is emerged out, and it is a C-shaped larva. Then this larva, it is feeding from the soil on the roots and pods of the groundnut crop, and the pupation, it is occurs inside the soils, and after that the adult, it is hibernating into the soil for next season. And there is a only generation per year. It means that it is a Winnie Holstein species of the these are the two species, Holotrichia serrata, Holotrichia consanguinea, is nothing but the Winnie Holstein species or Winnie Holstein insects, that is the white grub. These are the two species, Holotrichia serrata and Holotrichia consanguinea. Then this caterpillar, that is nothing but the grub, the grub, it is attack from the soils. It is feed on the roots and rootlets of the groundnut crop. As a result of feeding, in case of severe infestation, the infested plant, it can be easily pull out. This grub is also attack on the leaves by making a large hole on the surface, feeding on the pods by making a large hole on the surface of the pods and feeding in a content of the pods, and the pods become rotten and yield is directly reduced. This is the damage symptoms, withering and drying patches of in the infested plants due to the feeding of the white grub from soil. Then these are some of the recommended practices. Deep summer plowing, then we can use a light trap or install light trap, then collect the adult beetle by shaking the host plant, adult host plant trees. Then seed treatment with Chlorpyrifos and Cunalphos, soil application with carbofuran. These are some of the practices. Then metarhizum and soplee, this is one of the effective entomopathogenic fungus against the white grub. It is mixed with 500 kg of FIM and vermicompost, and we can apply in soil. Then soil drenching with a Chlorpyrifos, it is also effective against the root grub or white grub. Then next is termites. Two species, Odontotermes obesus and Microtermes obesi. It is the one of the we can say that the polyphagous pest, but it is the social insects. हिंस हैविंग ए फोर लाइफ स्टेजेस और फोर डिफरेंट कास्ट दैट इज द किंग क्वीन सोल्जर वर्कर. द इन्फेस्टेशन ऑफ द टर्माइट्स इट इज मच मोर इन रेड सैंडिलोम सॉइल एंड द इन्फ्लिक्ट द मोर सीरियस डैमेज इन द अन इरीगेटेड एरिया. इट इज अ सोशल इंसेक्ट. आफ्टर द मेल फीमेल मीटिंग द फीमेल इट इज सेटल डाउन इन टू द सॉइल एंड मेक ए टर्मिटोरिया एंड गिवज ए 1x पर सेकंड इन सॉइल. And then here the king, queen, soldier, worker are the four different adult caste and the worker are the damaging stages of this pest. The workers, it is attacked from the soils, penetrate and hollow out the tap root and stem thus kill the plant. As a result of feeding, wilting of the plant in patches occurs. Then also we can see here the bore holes into the pots and damage the seeds. It removes the soft corky tissue from between the veins of the pods, causing a scarifications, weaken the shells, make them liable to entry and growth of aspergillus flowers that produce the alpha toxins. It means that it directly attack on the pods by making a large hole on the surface of the pods, and the pods become rotten due to the entry of the aspergillus flowers fungus. Then these are the some of the recommended practices in that termitoria. We can destroy the termitoria or dig out the termitoria, and we can destroy the queen. Then we can use a well rotten organic manure. Then harvest the groundnut as soon as they are mature. Early removal of the produce from the field will be reduce the chance of the termites damage to the pots. Then apply the chlorpyrifos to control the termites, and we can also dusting the chlorpyrifos at the rate of 30 to 40 kg per hectare in soils before sowing in the endemic areas. Then next it is the sucking pest, that is the pod sucking bug, Elasmolemus sordidus. Here the both nymphs and adult are the damaging stages. The most important things about related to this pest is that this pest is attacked in both condition, field as well as in storage condition. Both nymphs and adults suck the cells up from the developing seeds and also from developing shoots. As a result, developing tender shoots. Then as a result of feeding, the seeds get shriveled, become rancid and give bitter taste, and it is unfit for human consumption and lose their oil percentage or oil content. For the management of this pod sucking bug, we can spray the crop with different recommended systemic insecticide. Then this is the minor pest, that is the jewel beetle. It is a coleopteran pest. It is attacked from the soils. The grubs burrows into the stem close to the soil surface and kill the plants. Then for the management of the jewel beetle, the deep summer plowing, and we can also use the decomposed organic manures. Then the manual destruction of infested plant stems may be help in the reduce the its populations. Then conserve the different biocontrol agents. Then application of granules chemicals from the soil, that is the carbofuran. Then this is also the minor pest, that is the wireworm and the false wireworm. It is also the coleopteran pest. The grubs, it is attacked from the soils on the roots and also feed on the pods by making a large hole on the surface of the pods and feeding inner content of the pods, and the pods become rotten and it is unfit for human consumption, and the seeds become shriveled and lose their oil content and germination percentage also. And this is also the minor pest, that is the earwig. Having an incomplete metamorphosis, having a three life stages, egg, nymphs and adult. The both nymphs and adult, it is suck the cells up from the developing pods or developing seeds. The egg laying takes place inside the soil, and after the hatching from the eggs, both nymphs and adult suck the cells up from the developing seeds. As a result of feeding, the seeds become shriveled and unfit for human consumption. Here in this picture you can see the adult, it is suck the cells up from the developing seeds and seeds unfit for human consumption. Then for the management practices, soil application with Marathon dust or any other dust formulation chemicals to reduce the or to control the earwig in the groundnut crop. Then these are the some of the recommended practices you can use to reduce the pest infestation in the IPM with the help of reduce the infestation of the pest in groundnut crop with the help of this IPM techniques. The first one is cultural practices. In cultural practices, we can use a trap crop as a soybean or cowpea against the leaf miner and the leaf hoppers. Then castor against the Spodoptera litura. Then we can use a tall crop or border crop, that is the pearl millet, sorghum and maize, to reduce the infestation of the thrips. Then vegetative trapping of red hairy caterpillar with the twigs of Jatropha and Calotropis, nymphs branches of, for trapping the adult white grub. Then for the mechanical control, we can remove the different egg masses which is present in the groundnut fields. We can collect and destroy the egg masses or late install larva also. We can use a bird purchase also. Then for the Spodoptera litura and for the Helicorpa, we can use a sex pheromone trap with a recommended lures and also use a light trap. Then azadirachtin and the neem seed kernel extract, it is a botanical insecticide, we can also use again this paste. Then SLNPV and HANPV are the two recommended entomopathogenic virus against the Spodoptera litura and the Helicorpa armigera respectively. Then Bacillus thuringiensis, it is one of the effective entomopathogenic bacteria against the all the Lepidopteran insects. Then Nomorrhea really are the entomopathogenic fungus, it is mostly used against the Spodoptera species. And then chemical control, these are the different chemical recommended chemicals against the leaf miner or defoliators, quinolphos, chlorpyrifos, thiocarb, like that. Then against the sucking pest, we can use a systemic insecticide like imidacloprid and acetamiprid. For white grub, seed treatment with chlorpyrifos. Then these are the some of the recommended or registered insecticides which is registers or recommended against the different insect pest population of groundnut, and it is recommended by the CIB and RC, Central Insecticide Board and Registration Committee. And these are also the registered insecticides. Then these are the different resistant varieties or tolerant varieties which is recommended or recommended by the different plant breeders, that is for kharif season, for rabi season. These are just some of the different varieties we can sown or sowing. Okay, thank you.